All the information in the poor man seems Bond, you still have difficulty getting bomb components. Well, bless your heart, Clyde, anyone can make a bomb. You can make one by using odds and ends available even during an enemy occupation. You start with a carton of book matches and cut off the heads. This is tedious work for one, but an evening's fun for the family if you can drag them away from the TV. The next step is to process the match heads for fuses. Put the match heads in a cup and fill it halfway with boiling water. Stir, and in a few seconds the paper will be separated and floating on top. Then pour the contents through a screen and into a bowl. Discard the paper from the heads and evaporate most of the liquid. When it's down to a thin mush, like this, it's time to make your fuses. For the fuses, you cut about 20 10-inch lengths of medium-sized cotton twine. Next, provide a metal surface, like a baking pan. Then put lengths of twine in the well-stirred mush, one at a time, and slosh them around. You might add a quarter teaspoon of mucilage glue to the mixture for sticking power. When they are well-soaked and coated, take a pair of tweezers and pull the fuse out by an end. Next, gently scrape down the fuse to remove clots and any excess mush. Then lay the fuse on the metal surface. When your fuses are nicely laid out, put them in a 200-degree oven for about 20 minutes. If you don't have an oven, use your food dryer, or else set them outside in the sun. When dry, release the fuses by running a razor knife or other sharp blade underneath them. These fuses should not go out, but don't bend them or handle them any more than necessary.